Hi, my lovelies. Today I'm going to give you my 9-week pregnancy update. For those of you who don't know me yet, if you're new to my channel, it's awesome that you found me. I am 47 years old. I started family quite late. My partner and I, we have a almost nine-year-old daughter, biologically. And we've been wanting to grow our family, and finally we're successful at becoming pregnant again. After having a double embryo transfer in the Czech Republic. These were donated embryos, so they're not genetically related to me or my partner. And today I'm going to give you my 9-week update. So today I'm 9 weeks and 2 days pregnant. And I want to tell you about some of the symptoms and also some of the things that happened last week. There was something very scary that happened. I get all into it. So the symptoms haven't really changed a lot. I feel that as of today, my symptoms are a little bit better, but let's talk about last week. And again, I said that before, my symptoms aren't the same every day. It does fluctuate a little bit. I found a good groove with eating now. I just eat, although I know that about 15 minutes after I get through eating, I start feeling really nauseous. So no matter what I eat, this will happen. And if I don't eat, this will happen. So I might as well eat. I have been eating very healthy food. That is not hard for me because it's what I've been doing for years. Honestly, I have not had the craving for anything junky or anything, or like carb loaded. I just eat like I always do. And although some things don't sound good to me, I've learned that once I put them in my mouth, they actually taste okay. So for the past few weeks, I kind of thought avocado would be really nasty to try. The thought of avocado was like, yuck. But then I actually made like a salad with tomato and avocado and cucumbers, and it was delicious. So while I ate it, it was just fine. And it doesn't matter what I eat afterwards. It's all like that weird aftertaste. And I have been taking my supplements. I'm keeping on taking my supplements. So I wanted to tell you about my midwife appointment that I had last week. I saw her last Wednesday when I was, 8 weeks and 3 days pregnant. And it felt so good because she took an hour to talk to me. Mainly we just talked. She gave me a few more tips for my nausea. And I have this one thing right here. This right here, it looks like a Band-Aid, but it has a little magnet on there that sticks out. And so she told me that whenever I feel the nausea coming in, she wants me to press on it for a minute or so. I can't really say that it has made a big difference. So I think these are all just things you can try. She also taped me. So she put like a Band-Aid right like below, like right here on my chest, on my lower chest. Also, I can't say that it really helped. She said that it's a common thing and it helps some women. I can't say that it made a big difference. The biggest difference I feel when I actually just lie down for at least half an hour, I try to take a nap. And this is another thing. I did say before that I haven't felt extreme tiredness, but here's the thing, when I do lay down to take a nap, I mean, yesterday I took a nap and I legit dreamed. I actually had dreams. I'm someone who normally can't sleep during the day. I just can't. My body knows it's daytime, and so I just don't go into this full sleep mode. I might be able just to, I don't know, nap away for a couple minutes and then I would wake up, but this time I can sleep during the day, and I do think it's because of being pregnant. And of course, being pregnant with twins is, I can tell that it is a lot more work for my body than being pregnant with one. This is my 4th pregnancy overall. My 1st pregnancy with my daughter, I carried her to term, had a natural home birth, and then I had 2 miscarriages. I was pregnant up to 7 weeks, and then last time up to 10 weeks. And I have to say that this time the symptoms are like really through the roof. I have not thrown up yet, and that is something that probably will not happen because my body doesn't really do it easily. Even when I have like a stomach bug or anything, it's really hard for me to get to that point to actually really throw up. So unless I'm truly sick and there is a virus in me, my body just doesn't do it. So I'm glad, because it's horrible for me. That would be horrible. It's one of the worst things to me. So I'm really happy. I can manage the nausea, and I feel that whenever while I actually work, or like while I'm doing this video, just being active does make it better. But then when I, you know, right afterwards, when I actually slow down, then I can feel like, ooh, that was a lot of work. And actually right now, as I'm sitting here, I'm so, so tired. So my midwife appointment was really nice. I'm sorry, I'm all over the place. So, I mean, we talked a lot about different things. We talked about birth plans, and, you know, I want to have as natural of a birth as possible. And of course, always keeping in mind that I want it always to be safe for me and the babies. So I am aware of all the risks with twins, but then also there are a lot of twin pregnancies that go to full term, completely healthy, that, you know, end up being delivered vaginally. So I'm already picturing that. I'm just really thinking about those images. And I think that does help. I'm also reading some books. I'm gonna put the links below. I forgot the names right now, but some really great books. One is about twin pregnancy, and in particular, I felt it had kind of an undertone of just like, oh, it's so much work, and I felt so bad. It's basically a mom telling, you know, her own experience, but also that she did manage to deliver vaginally, and you know, how it all came to be, and that nutrition is so extremely important. She has some studies in there that she mentions. So it's also science-based. But I felt like she had, kind of a general undertone of, well, it's crazy, and I felt like so bad sometimes, and I felt like a beached whale. I'm reading another book right now, and again, it's like the natural pregnancy book or something like that. I will put the links below. And I got them as a Kindle, and I've been lying in my bed and reading, so that's something that is so awesome. Lying down and reading makes everything better, because I don't have to focus on feeling sick. Plus, it makes me excited. I already read the book by Ina May Gaskin. That's her name. She's a midwife, and she has a classic book called, like, I don't know, Natural Birthing or something like that. I read it in German back then, but basically it's all about how birth isn't like a disease or anything, but it's a very natural and normal process that women for millions of years have gone through, and most of the time there's no need for intervention. And I'm very happy that we have modern medicine, and I would be the first one to say, like, yes, please, I need it, you know, if I really need it. But a lot of times it's just not necessary. So I want to try to see what's possible in a natural way. That's how I did it with my transfer. That's why I did a natural cycle transfer, just taking progesterone. And other than that, we just relied on my natural processes, because I still ovulate, you know, and my body is still doing its thing, although I'm a little bit older. So while it does that, why not use the natural processes? Because we know very little about, like, the entire picture. Okay, so midwife appointment was great. Now, that day, that was last Wednesday, I remember. I don't know, but being pregnant, like, at first, it made me, like, not want to be intimate too much. And of course, the first 2 weeks, the clinic told me, you know, no intimacy with my partner, because, you know, like, no intercourse because of infection or something, that we want to be on the safe side. So we didn't. And then I also didn't take baths. And then I don't know, I was a little, I just didn't feel like it. And so last week, I just felt like I was getting such a desire. We were intimate on Wednesday, and everything was great. It was wonderful. And then later on, I went to the bathroom and I got so shocked because I saw blood. And it wasn't just a little bit. It was like, I don't know. Of course it was, you know, mixed with stuff. And so, and plus I'm taking the supports, the suppositories, the progesterone suppositories. That, it's all like nasty. Anyway, I'm sorry for the TMI, but I don't know any other way to describe it. I got so scared. I didn't tell my partner anything. I was like, he's just gonna worry. I just don't want anyone to worry about me. I want to stay positive. But I did write an email to my doctor because it's really hard to get a hold of them by phone. But if you write them an email, they will get in touch with you ASAP. So the next morning, I got a message back from my doctor. And, you know, I explained to him that, you know, we were intimate. And then I assume it could be like a contact bleeding. And then he said, probably that's what it is, but you know, and the bleeding had stopped completely by that morning. So it was just a little bit that night, and then it stopped. And probably, you know, he said, like, if, you know, take extra magnesium to relax all the muscles, and just if anything changes, that I want, you know, that they want me to contact them and possibly come in to check. But I felt like everything else was okay. I didn't feel any cramping or anything. Everything was fine. I felt as pregnant as ever. Very nauseous, very sick, and all the symptoms, you know, up to this day. So I am thinking it was just a contact bleeding because of the fact that when you are pregnant, especially when you're pregnant with twins, you have more hormones in your system, and the hormones cause your cervix and everything in there to be very much, you know, it's very vascular. It's like there, it's the blood vessels are very, very sensitive. And so it's very easy for a little blood vessel to, you know, to burst. But that's not a bad thing. So that was very, very scary. But I feel really good now. And so we just have to be a little bit more careful. So my next ultrasound is Wednesday, like a week from this Wednesday. So I, you know, of course I didn't want to do a lot of ultrasounds, but I totally think it makes a lot of sense with twins. We want to always check that they're both growing and that, you know, placentas are in the correct place. Sometimes they fuse. That's not a bad thing, but it's just generally a good idea to kind of just really keep a closer eye on a twin pregnancy, which I'm totally on board with. Although in the beginning I said, like, I only want like the 3 ultrasounds that they offer, but now we're going to do 1 ultrasound every month. So that's going to be a week from Wednesday. And other than that, there's not a lot of new stuff. Everything else is still the same. Rest, tenderness, sometimes more, sometimes less. And you know, like the tiredness is hitting me a little bit more now. The nausea is always there. I feel like today it's a little bit better, but it's been there all the time. It seems to never go away, and I feel like I've also gotten used to it and I can manage it now because I know, like, I'm just gonna go ahead and eat normally. And I think other than that, there's nothing else I can report. Now, I would like to know from you guys what kind of videos would you like me to make, because of course, you know, there's the weekly updates, but you know, at a certain point, there's not that much, probably not that many events or a lot that happens or a lot that changes. Oh, my bump? No. Really, I feel like, and I don't want to show you my, it's like I got such a belly. I got such a food belly. Oh, I did gain 1 pound, which I think is good. I want to gain more weight, and I eat quite, I mean, not like a pig or anything, but I eat really well, and I don't eat, you know, I eat adequate amounts, I'd say that, but I have only gained 1 pound so far, which is kind of crazy. I thought I'd start gaining more. So, yeah, there's definitely, when I lie halfway inclined, I can definitely start feeling a little bit of a bump on, you know, my lower, on the lower parts of my abdomen, which that must be where my uterus is, of course. Anything that's above that is just my fat gut, which it's good. It's all good now. I can take care of that after the babies are born. I can start working out again next year. But for now, it's all about eating well, eating enough, and especially for twin pregnancy, I read it over and over again that getting a lot of good calories, nutrient-dense calories in is so good. It's gonna set your babies up for good growth so that at the end, the birth has the best possible outcome. But coming back, why am I all over the place? What kind of videos would you like me to make? I can show you what I eat. I do eat very healthy and maybe it gives you some ideas. I love watching those kind of videos. I don't know if you love them, but I could show you what I eat. I could also do more of like a vlog style update where I don't just sit in front of the camera, but where, you know, I incorporate a little bit more of like just life to where like how my pregnancy plays out in my everyday life. Let me know what you would like to see. I still want to make that video. I'm going to make it very soon about how I knew that I'm expecting twins before I even had a positive pregnancy test the positive pregnancy test, of course, didn't show me like if I had twins or not, but before the ultrasound, I was so certain, and I'm going to make a video about why I knew. Okay, that's all for today. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'd love for you to subscribe if you have not, to follow my journey. And if you are also on this journey, whether you are trying to conceive or you're already pregnant, no matter if you're doing it naturally or through embryo adoption like we did, or IVF, I would love to connect with you. I follow several of you who also watch my channel, especially those of you who are very close to, you know, my journey. Like if you had transfers around the time that I did, chances are we follow each other. And I think that's very interesting just to kind of hear, you know, what other people experience. And it just feels good to have someone to talk about that kind of stuff, right? I mean, these are the things you just don't go out and talk to people about. Even your partner. No. He's like, okay, are you feeling? How are you feeling? But he just doesn't want to know all the details about, like, all the stuff. So, thank you for watching. Have a great day, and I'll hope to see you soon. Bye.